welcome to Battle Arena, the first and only televised airsoft tournament. Battle Arena is a place where real men fight fair and hard. Your hosts for this show are Tim Kirby and...
Sean Gizatulin. Airsoft is a tactical sports game, a war game. Airsoft teams copy various military units from across the world. The weapons used in airsoft are exact copies of real guns, but they fire plastic pellets going at 130 meters per second.
This is all just a game, but the emotions, the passion is real, which is exactly what we are about to show you through the eyes of each player right here on Battle Arena. Today we have an exhibition match between Russia and France. France is represented by Team Mitchell, an all-French team surprisingly led by a Russian national.
The Russians are represented by Team Snegiri, who came in second place during Battle Arena Tournament Season 1.
The battle is going to be fought in this building. The building is symmetrical and has two wings connected via the yard in the center.
According to our rules, the team must capture and hold the flag, which is a heavy rescue dummy we call Valera. Valera sits in the central yard between the two wings of the building, east and west. Both teams have two possible ways to Valera, either through the windows or the connecting corridor. If you've just joined in, let's recap the rules. Each game has two teams of five players.
Each player has one primary weapon, plus six mags, one secondary weapon with unlimited mags, one grenade per round, and a knife.
Any hit to the body or head is considered a kill. Any hit to any of the limbs is considered an injury. An injured player cannot use his damaged limb until he or his teammates can bandage the said limb.
And you can still use your handgun and your knife, if you're tricky enough. In the tournament, there's three games to a match. For each game you win, the team gets 1 point. The match is held until one team gets 2 points. Best of three, basically.
Okay, the coin toss is done. Now the teams are going to assume their starting positions outside the building.
Team Mitchell is in red, and they're gonna start in the western sector. The Snegiri are in blue in the east. Hey, why are the French wearing red against Russia? This makes no sense, Sean.
Because we don't like cliches, and we're here to break them.
Oh, yes, we are stereotype busting here on Battle Arena.
Okay, so Russian team here preparing to enter the building. Match begins, round number one. Remember, people, each round lasts 7 minutes.
And playing very aggressively, which is correct. If you remember back, Sean, in the original tournament, there was what I called the corridor of death. Well, this is an entire yard of death. This is a huge...
Plus a corridor of death.
Yes, exactly.
Corridor of death times two. Here's Popov. That's not a very common name for a French guy, Popov.
Yes, we shall call him Le Popov.
Le Popov or something like this. Yeah. Yes, totally. Mitchell, Russian national, speaks a fluent French and fluent Russian.
That could be an advantage, because when he's screaming in French, only his team understands.
That's true. Is Mitchell speaking Russian? Why is he speaking Russian to his French team?
That's
they don't
very
speak Russian
confusing.
For sure. We know that for a
fact. It's sort of like a live action role play or something, Sean. They're trying to be accurate to their characters.
That's right. So it looks like a stalemate around the yard. Nobody's crazy enough to go in there. Udav, one of the most effective players of Battle Arena, is about to toss that grenade into the yard. Let's see. Get anyone?
Grenade out? Where is it?
What? That's a dud! That's a dud, man!
Dud.
That grenade was a dud! I'm telling you! Yeah, there was a misfire. It
perhaps.
Did not blow up at all.
Sean, let me tell you something. The word sabotage is French in origin. I'm not saying anything, I'm just saying.
Entirely possible. Zaraza means a disease in Russian, okay? So that's a French disease. Huh, interesting.
You know, some of our soldiers in World War II came back with some French diseases. I'll tell you what, Sean.
Let's not talk about this right now. Mitchell is having difficulties with his gun, it appears. FS2B, that's an interesting choice of a name.
Looks like he's very hip-hop.
He's the oldest player on the French team. And Udav, again, now he's got a replacement grenade. Via one of our referees, grenade out this time. Oh, Popov! Oh, no! Oh, yes! Udav takes out Popov. Minus one player for the French guys.
The beauty of that throw, the beauty of the bounce. Excellent. Well played.
Very, very, very
down,
good.
Down!
Very good.
Down!
Job. Okay.
And now why is Udav screaming
Zaraza,
down?
Zaraza's returning the favor. But no results.
Short.
No results.
Short.
Yep. Duff is, I mean, you gotta move this guy. He's not afraid of anything. John's looking at Valera in the middle.
And the main thing is Duff's able to control this position.
You know what I'm wondering? Why are they not moving around them corridors and trying to outflank each other? You know, they seem to be so concentrated on the central yard.
I think because once, as I've noticed, Sean, in our tournaments, once someone has Valera, it's really hard to get him back. And I think that they're just afraid of giving up their attention, giving up the central square.
That's very true. If you're going to move people away from those windows, yeah, you're essentially making it easier for the other guys to capture Valera. Okay, Cross and Tolsty are being held back. Ooh, Duff's moving in, man. Look at this guy go.
And look, he's getting the covering fire. This is something I understand. Why is he trying to keep his gun up? Grab, run, run! You've got covering fire, run!
If you're doing something as risky as moving into the yard, you might as well go full ahead, you know?
Yeah.
And not just stay behind those barrels. Mitchell's giving out commands in perfect French now. What is going on? Mitchell Cross? Team down one guy.
I'm not quite sure what Cross is doing in the corridor. Yeah. He just seems to be looking around. That's okay. Oh, moving.
Looks like
moving to the window of death.
Looks like some furniture from a very famous Swedish company here.
Yes.
Udav's finally moving back into
he's
the window.
Moving.
Oh no! He's shot in the back by Sparta.
And he's down.
And he is down indeed. Down for good. That was a back shot, meaning he is out. So now Udav's asking his fellow teammate, can you drag Valera all the way in through the window? Can you get him into the room?
Dead teammates are allowed to speak. Unrealistic, but effective.
Yes. Dead guy cannot move,
no,
but
he can
still talk.
Yeah. The Russian team is strategizing.
Yeah, they're trying to figure out what to do now. But they got the upper hand, even though it's four versus four now. Valera's closer to their position.
Valera is less than 1 meter away from the window. All they have to do is get one arm out there and drag him. Drag 80 kilograms, get an arm out there. Get him!
Man, should you really do it? I mean, they already got the upper hand. Might as well just stay and, you know, lock this place down. Mayor's moving. Oh, he's injured!
He's injured!
That's a hand injury. I think it was shot in his hand.
Well, Sean, the reason they have to get him is right now they're not controlling Valera technically, and they can't win unless he's under control.
Grenade out by the French team. Again, no results, huh? These French are not really lucky with them grenades today.
This is an interesting moment. The French have decided to use two men to bandage one when one guy could bandage himself. Interesting tactic.
It's all about the team play and caring for your teammates, I guess, I suppose. But then again, why waste two men on an action that can be done by one?
I'm baffled.
Okay. French intensifies.
Yes, the French language intensifies and mystifies because I don't speak French. Maybe they should write it down so you'd understand it better.
Udav, the downed Russian captain. Mayor, see, bandaging himself, and he's now
back
in
action.
Indeed, back in action. So can he drag Valera all the way in?
That's not Valera.
Oh, he's
got to
get Udav out of the way.
The corpse of Udav is in the way.
He looks like he needs more space to work with. Look at that. Look at him go. Look at him go. What was that move?
I don't know.
What would you call that? If it was a dance move. Tolsty just took out Zarazi in the meanwhile, but we didn't capture that footage, sadly. Because it looks like there was some problem with one of the cameras at the time.
So now we have a situation where we have two guys playing doctor and only one guy focusing on the battle. Come on, guys.
Three guys left for Mitchell. It's almost at the end of the round. Less than a minute left on the clock. Mayor is dragging him in. Mayor is major in Russian.
The dead Udav is screaming, do it, man, do it, get him.
Okay, the French are becoming a little bit more aggressive, but 30 seconds on the clock. Can they do it? Can they bring Valera home?
Oh, someone got clipped.
John's keeping them at bay. They got some really good covering positions protecting this window.
Oh, my what a grenade shit. Toss. A brick-breaking grenade toss. The power of Cross.
Russian airsoft grenades are so badass, they can break brick walls. 10 seconds until the end of the round. 5 seconds
get
left
him
now. What? Oh, man. 3, 2, 1, and that's it. This is it. Round number one.
And the referees are ruling that Valera was under the control of the Russian team. The Russian team takes the round.
Yeah, if you're within less than 1 meter from Valera, it means
yours.
He's yours. Now, let's take a look at what's going to happen in round two of Battle Arena Exhibition Match, Russia versus France. Now team's gonna swap their positions for this battle.
Yeah, we're switching sides, but the strategy remains the same, and I expect that both teams are gonna get really aggressive in the first few seconds.
Okay. Do you think that will in any way affect the psychology of the French? Look, they're aiming at Russians already. What's going on?
That's just a
little friendly joke there, I guess.
Yeah, some tomfoolery, as they used to say back in the olden days.
All right, the round begins. 7 more minutes. Can the French win this one? Okay, what's going on? Already Tolstoy takes out FS2B, man. Losing their very first guy within the first 10 seconds of the second round. That's, what the hell is going
on? That's incredible, but that's the thing. It's a very open room, open window. Put the covering fire in, got lucky.
Looks like the French are getting reckless. They realize that if they lose this one, it's all over for them. So they're getting reckless. Do you think that's the case?
I think it could be. And it's also, this is a very draining sport. Both teams did fantastic physically in the first round, but the fatigue could set in pretty soon.
Udav, was that? Yeah, that was again! He takes out Popov's set twice in a row, man. Twice in a row. The very same player. Can you believe that?
Le Popov goes pop! And he's out.
Man, he's got some major beef with this guy. I don't know what's going on. But
Mitchell reloading already. Mitchell's just burning through ammo.
John in the corridor. Mitchell's just shooting all over the place. Udav, look at this. Responding calmly with very controlled short bursts. Like Mitchell's just going ramble over him.
But he's still providing the covering fire. He's getting the shots in there.
Another grenade out by Udav. Udav's about to grenade out.
Grenade.
Where fire to? Fire in the hole, and it goes where? Goes to the room with Mitchell. Mitchell jumps out of the window just in the nick of time and takes cover behind them barrels. Very
now
close
the
to
French,
Valerina.
Now the French team's starting to play. Now they're getting aggressive. That was epic.
That was epic. Look at this little gap. Oh. And he actually shot him through the gap, man. Can you believe it?
The half-inch gap. Oh, it's just not Mitchell's day.
Man, Udav. Udav's so badass. Look at this. Two players left on Team Mitchell versus five.
And he's got Valera again, second time, moving backwards. But why isn't he running? Turn your back and run! Run!
He's just being careful about this. Maybe they don't want to lose anyone in this match and humiliate the French. But then again, you see, I'm actually starting to believe in French watching this. You know why? They're not surrendering.
No, there is that historical stereotype that France surrenders. I think that stereotype's a little bit unfair. But one thing I can say is that France has fought in a lot of wars. They keep fighting, and that's the important thing.
That's true. I like these French guys, certainly. Udav takes out Zaraza. Wow, beautiful shot there. Zaraza couldn't even react in time. One player left for Team Mitchell. One. Mm. And all five Russians are still active. Man, if you were that Sparta left, by the way, Sparta left on Team Mitchell, what would you do if you were him?
Oh, gosh. You know, it's one of these things where, Sean, I think that since this isn't your real life, you got to have some fun. I'd charge.
Yeah.
Infantry charge, try to storm, try to get a move on. Because what can you do with one guy?
If you're lucky, you can take out one or maybe two.
Only Chuck Norris can move room to room and pick off one guy at a time. He's not Chuck Norris. He just got to charge.
That's right.
And conversely, the Russian team has Valera. They have four guys. Maybe it's time to try to take them out with the combat knife.
I know, yeah, seriously.
First knife kill of the league.
Yeah, that would be epic. And certainly very Russian to charge headlong into enemy machine gun fire. Russians are really, really good at doing this.
Russia has own tactic.
Yes, that's right.
Choke with dead body. No, I'm just kidding. Actually,
show him a little trick I learned. Commissar, prepare machine gun.
Actually, that's a stereotype about Russian tactics formed by a lot of video games and not by real history.
Yeah, you see, that's how Russians wage war, apparently. I mean... No surprise they beat the Germans. Okay, now, what can I say? It's not going very well for the French team. I mean, if you can call it a team now, there's only one guy left.
Yeah, we're already... Half the round is down. Down to one guy. He's suppressed into basically the rear room. He's not even in the front room. I don't know what... Wait,
what is John doing?
He's carefully setting up his gun Oh my god, it's a portable turret.
It's a portable turret. Yeah, he's trying to make it look like a dummy, like it's an active player. He's got his pistol out.
Wow.
And interesting.
Maybe that's an interesting tactic when there's one guy left who can't really even see that barrel.
And they're trying to multiply already. Yeah. Very interesting. That's very Russian, okay. I suppose. Okay. if you were Udav right now, what would you do? You got this guy locked down pretty much. He's surrounded. You got five people against one. Now maybe would be a good time to,
I think.
Oh look! What Popov's doing?
Yeah.
Oh, Popov's offering his grenade. He's still got his grenade left.
Yeah, so you can take the grenades off dead bodies.
Yeah, you can take weapons and ammo and grenades. Yeah, no problem. Okay, grenade. Now that was a desperate throw. Look at this. That was a That wasn't very well done.
He kind of threw it like a shuffle pass, which is an odd choice.
Interesting. Russians don't even care about this. They didn't. Yeah. They didn't even react. Oh, John's injured. John's injured by
Could
Sparta.
Could this be the comeback? The epic comeback.
Seriously. Well, I mean, injuring somebody when you're up against five people, that actually deserves some praise. I mean, Sparta did really well. John's injured.
But unfortunately, he's got that bandage. He's got a lot of time to get it on his arm.
Yeah, certainly. He's got enough cover to do this at the same time. Four people covering him. And they got Valera. It's 1.5 minutes left, so I don't really see how the French are gonna turn this.
Oh, we've got some terrain adjustment here. That is legal. I remind you, it is legal to move terrain.
Yeah, if you're strong enough. So he barricaded that doorway, meaning that the French guy now has one less escape route.
Well, speaking of strong, you know, that was pretty easy for Duff to move that barrel full of gravel, and he could pick up Valero with one hand real easy. Maybe he's just mutantly strong.
Yeah, yeah.
That could be.
Freakishly strong.
Who knows? He doesn't look it, but maybe he is. But you know what? About the physicality of the guys, I think that in this exhibition match, both teams are displaying better physicality than the previous tournament. These guys are running hard, they're moving, and they're not getting tired.
Less than a minute left on a clock. Mitchell's just looking at what's going on.
He's looking at his hopes go down the toilet.
Yeah, can't really do anything. And Udav's just taking pot shots at this little opening in the wall, and there's 30 seconds left on a clock. This is it. Hmm. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
Now's the time to attack, French guys. Okay, Mitchell says this is a Russian TV show. You're supposed to die a hero here.
And he's right. Even the Russian team agrees that that's awesome propaganda. I think he's convinced them. I think they're going to charge.
No, we're...
Let's pick spiders!
Yes! Forward. Oh, finally! There's the charge coming out! Stuff's moving in! And what? Okay, 2 seconds left, 1 second left. Almost quite. This is the end of round two, one more.
Thank goodness it ended on a charge. I would have hated to see time run out while they're just standing there.
One more point for Team Snegiri. Wow, dude, that was really hard today. These guys move really fast. I was injured when I was trying to get the dummy through the window. Well, we were shooting, we were killing. Man, these guys are really fast. They're also slim, not like me. Well, what can I say? I mean, I guess grenades are my thing. Well, Valera is kind of heavy too. I'm surprised that one of their oldest guys was moving the fastest there. Well, what can I say? C'est la vie. Yeah, I've played all over the world. Here, it's more like a sport. I hail from Corsica, and I've never seen bad weather. Here, I only see bad weather, dirt and mud and stuff, and I like it very much. What I was surprised the most with when I came here was the attitude of Russians towards French. It was my kids that brought me to Airsoft. My wife also travels with us, but she normally just cooks at the camping. Well, what can I say? It was a great game, so I hope that with Battle Arena, we can have more of such games happening. This is certainly, you know, a good way to get some camaraderie going between different nations.
And grow the league. This is not a Russia-only league. We want foreign teams to participate in the next matches in Battle Arena. We've been Tim Kirby and Sean Gizatulin.
See you next time on Battle Arena.